So now basically we've had that one already, so you know what, let's just dive in by setting up our login page and sign up page. So this part is going to cover the controller and the view section. Right, so to you work with the login page, you are still going to be using the WTSS. WTSS login demo. Alright, so let's just check this. Login template. I'm not sure that is the right one. So let's just search on login template. Okay. Delete this. Delete this. Okay. So let's check this one. Okay. This one is not what I was expecting. So we're not going to be making use of this. Alright. Let us wait for this to load up. Okay. So this is loaded already. Let's check if we can see a form here. So basically we can't find a form here, so let's just code this by ourselves. So before we get started, we have to move to the intro because I need to show you how you can work with styles and work with the product file styles, CSS, HTML and so on and so forth. So let's just go to home instead. We are gonna download the files. Okay, it's okay. This is a very, very bad network. I don't know what you're doing with it. Alright, so I can get it. Okay, so good. So, this is it right here. So, let's just copy this. Okay, we can download it. So, let's just download this. I see something I wanted to do it. So, let's just click on this. And we're going to load this right, so Ctrl A, Ctrl C, then go to this place. Your public folder, create a new folder called assets. Inside the assets folder, create a new folder called CSS. So inside the CSS, you create a new folder called www.css. So now you can paste it in there. Alright, so then save. Okay, so close this. We don't need that again. Let's go back, close this. So now let's look for the input, the form. Okay, the input, okay, this is the form. Okay, make it for the form. Alright, so let's pick one out of this. I'm actually like kind of like nice. Okay, I think this is okay. Let's just pick this one for the login. So try yourself. Now let's keep that. So to make this work, now view folder, let's create a new folder. So it's good to group your folders very well. So this is gonna be alt slash authentication. Inside the alt folder is gonna be create a new file. It's gonna be login.php. Okay, so this is gonna be a PHP file. Then the controller, I'm just gonna create a new file. This is gonna be what should I name this? Okay, before we do that, let's create a new folder first. This is gonna be alt. Also, make sure it's capital letter. Then this is gonna be alt also. Alt.php. Make sure it's capital letter. Good. So what we do here is just head over to this place. Let's copy everything here. Control C. Go to the alt. Then paste this here. You know here we have to extend this. So this is gonna be alt. Alright. So save. So it's pointing to this place, but we cannot actually access it, but let's try and access it first. If I take a look at the route here, let's refresh this. And if we should take a look at the route here. Let's show the route. So we have nothing from there. So because we haven't set our route free, because check this. This is gonna be, I think, index.php/port/port. Okay. Okay, maybe this isn't folding up, so basically codeigniter4 only just for keep on doing that. So let's do index.php/cut. So we're in the folder, so we want to access the index page. Basically I actually don't spend some time on this because I know this is a pain in the ass, so I don't do this. So basically what you have to do is just head over to this. Just press Ctrl P to search the route.php. So this is where we are gonna be assigning our route. So right here we can do route, then we are going to point it to get method. And this is gonna be /login. So the index page is gonna be login. This is gonna be auth index. So let's save this. And I should go back there and do /login. Okay, so we have a call fire. Particularly I think I have to do auth /. I don't know, I'm just thinking I have to do that. Okay, so controller method is not found at /auth index. Okay, let's check the auth again. So we have the index here. Basically, to save stress, let's just move this to the controller instead. Yes. So let's move that to the controller and let's delete the folder. We actually don't need it. Just for reference purpose. So after you've deleted that, you can just go to the route path. Let's delete this and save this. This should work now. Okay, good. So this is working now. So we are still pointing to the data, so we don't want to point to it. We want to point to auth /login. Alright, so let's reload this now. Now you can see we have an empty screen because. So let's close this. I don't want the view to bright to show the views also, then let's close this. Now, so this has loaded up already, so let's just Ctrl A, Ctrl C. Then head over to this place and paste this here. So this is gonna be login. This is gonna be username. This is gonna be email address, and let's turn this to email. This is gonna be password. This is gonna be password as well. And this one is gonna be login. This is gonna be password. Also, so let's save this. Now if I should go back there and reload this, we are not actually going to do what we want, so we are going to delete this and access our assets /css/w3.css. So let's save this, go back there and let's reload. Now you can see we have our login form ready. It's obvious like this, I don't know why. Let's check if we can have a container. Okay, yeah, so we have containers there. Maybe the container is going to touch besides it. Okay. So let's copy this particular container. Let's add it over here. Hey, no. No, let's just type this out. This will be div. Class equals to w3 container. Okay, so let's come here and close the div. Save, so let's go over there back. Refresh. Okay, so this seems better now. Now let's go around and check if we can have a padding. I don't know if there's padding there. So there should be no. Okay, yes, there's padding.